Good morning, students. In the operating system lecture series, today we will discuss important topic, that is security and semantics, consistency semantics also we will discuss. So let's start. Just wait for a minute. Okay. So today we will discuss consistency and security. So the topics to be covered are consistency semantics, security problems, and user authentication. Consistency semantics. Consistency semantics deals with the consistency between the views of shared files on a network system. When one user changes the file, when do other users see the changes? At first glance, this appears to have all of the synchronization issues we have discussed. So, you know, in the first glance, it appears that, you know, it's a synchronization issue. But unfortunately, the long delays involved in network operations prohibit the use of atomic operations. In the Unix semantics, the Unix file system uses the following semantics. One, it will write to an open file are immediately visible to any other user who has the file open. One implementation uses a shared location pointer, which is adjusted for all sharing users. The file is associated with a single exclusive physical resource, which may delay some accesses. Session semantics. The Andrew file system, that is called AFS, Andrew file system, uses the following semantics. What it does writes to an open file, not immediately visible to other users. When a file is closed, any changes made become available only to user who open the file at a later time. According to these semantics, a file can be associated with multiple, possibly different views, almost no. In the session semantics also, constraints are imposed on scheduling accesses. No user is delayed in reading or writing their personal copy of the file. Andrew file system may be accessible by system around the world. Access control is maintained through somewhat complicated access control list, which may grant access to the entire world, literally, or to specifically named users accessing the files from specifically named remote environments. There is also one term that is called immutable shared files semantic. So under this system, when a file is declared as shared by its creator, when a person who is creating the file and it is declared that it is a shareable, so it becomes immutable and the name cannot be reused for any other resource. Hence, it becomes read-only and shared access is simple. Okay, so since this shared access will be simple because it is read-only, so nobody can make any changes in this. That is why it will become simple thing. Now we will come to the security. In the protection, we have seen that protection deals with protecting files and other resources from accidental misuse by cooperating users sharing a system, generally using the computer for normal purposes. In the security, deals with protecting systems from deliberate attacks. The attacks which are, you know, attacked deliberately. either internal or external, from individuals intentionally attempting to steal information, damage information, or otherwise deliberately break havoc in some manner. So what are the violations of the security? The most common types of violation include breach of confidentiality, theft of private or confidential information such as credit card numbers, trade secrets, patents, secret formulas, manufacturing procedures, medical information, financial information, etc. Breach of integrity, unauthorized modification of data, which may have serious indirect consequences. For example, a popular game or other program source code could be modified to open up security holes on user system before being released to the public. In this violations is breach of availability. So breach of availability, unauthorized destruction of data, often just for the fun of causing havoc and for bragging rights. Vandalism of websites is a common form of this violation. Theft of service, unauthorized use of resources such as theft of CPU cycle, installation of daemons running an unauthorized file server, or tapping into the target's telephone or network services. Another important violation is denial of service. It is preventing legitimate users from using the system, often by overwhelming the system with an excess of request for service. Now, the common attacks. The common attacks are, number one is mass quadrant, man in the middle attack, and replay attack. What happens in the mass quadrant? In the mass quadrant, there is if there are two person, let's say sender and receiver, sender sending information to the receiver, but there mass quadrant is when a sender is sending information to the receiver, there is one man in between them that pretend that it is a sender, and receiver think that the information is sending by the sender, but it is sending by the if L is B is Bob, then this U, this is a person which is not having a good intention. So that is mass quadrant. Man in the middle attack is the same as the mass quadrant, but in the man in the middle attack, a person sits between the sender and the receiver, and it is dealing with not only with the receiver, it is also dealing with the sender and the receiver. So sender thinks it's sending the information to the receiver, but actually it is sending to this middle person, and this middle person is sending this information, maybe modified information, to the receiver. So that is called man in the middle. A third person, which is unauthorized person, sits in between the sender and the receiver. That is called the man in the middle attack. That is also the replay attack. It can modify the information, sending back information to others. So that is also called the replay attack. Mean to say, modified some information and sending back. Now, we will discuss this level of protection. So in the level of protection, there are different level of protection. Number one is physical level of protection. Second one is the human protection. In this human, phishing will be there, dumpster diving will be there, password cracking will be there, operating system level protection will be there, and the network network protection will also be there. Okay. Network protection will also be there. So first of all, we will start from this. Okay, so in the level of protection, we will discuss that at the physical level, human level is phishing. Phishing, as you know, and the website is there and somebody else is making another website similar to that. Dumpster diving, password cracking. They are making some, you know, password cracking algorithm and operating system level and the network. These are the, you know, level of protection. So we can also, you know, protect the at the physical level. Physical level, you know, the system is that physically one can harm. So user authentication, one is the different user authentication are there. One is called the password. Passwords, you know, is a very basic thing. Or everybody, you know, using some password for securing the system. However, there are, you know, different mechanism or available in the cryptography so that one can harm these password and easily they can, you know, crack these passwords. So after these passwords, this encrypted passwords have come into the picture. And in the encrypted password, the password uses this encryption, mean to say this password is encrypting some different, you know, use some encryption algorithm that has been designed and tested rigorously so that, you know, one cannot identify the password very easily. Nowadays, one time password that is also called OTP. OTP is used to, you know, whenever you are making a transaction, you are receiving a one-time password in your system or your mobile, so that if somebody else has seen your password, this OTP, you will write down the OTP and, you know, you add, it is actually valid for some particular time, so nobody else can, you know, misuse that thing. So OTP is a very good thing for the password. Now the, you know, next that is biometrics is also there. There are many other variation on the use of password for authentication. Palm or hand reader are common for secure physical access. For example, access to a data center. These readers match stored parameters against what is being read from their hand reader pad. Okay. Fingerprint reader have become accurate and cost effective and should become more common in the future. So, you know, this biometrics, so nobody else can use this thing. So these are the some security, you know, user authentication sort of things which we can done. That is password, encrypted password, one-time password and biometrics. So I will, you know, stop here. Thank you, and thank you for patience listening. In the next lecture, we will discuss threats, program threats, and system threats. So these all we will discuss in the next lecture. Till then, thank you, and